Hello everyone, today we are going to deal with the poem 2.1 Cherry Tree, written by Ruskin Bond. Ruskin Bond is an Indian author of British descent. The Room on the Roof was his first novel. In 1992, he had received the Sahitya Academy Award for English Writing in India. And then later, in 1999, he had received the Padma Shri. Okay, about this poem, Cherry Tree, it is the poet who is expressing his ecstasy. Ecstasy meaning extreme happiness over a tree which has taken almost 8 years to grow. Okay, so let's try to understand the poem in detail. Cherry Tree, I'm referring to page 66 of the textbook. Cherry Tree. 8 years have passed since I placed my cherry seed in the grass. Must have a tree of my own, I said. See, all of us have some dream or a desire in our life. To own something, to achieve something. So here, the poet has had a dream of or a desire of planting a tree. You know, because those who are interested in gardening would definitely understand the excitement of how gardening is. Okay, so 8 years, so this is the time period, you know, he remembers this very fondly, that it is somewhere 8 years that has passed and he has planted a seed in the grass, and this is done with the intention that he wanted to see something of his own. You know, when you start up a business, you want to see that growing, you know, somewhere, someday you want to see it as established. So someday he wanted to see the fruits of this tree, maybe. That is the reason why he has planted this tree and watered it once and went to bed. But then if you want to achieve something in life, you have to be determined and consistent. Take care of it. Okay. You cannot be just careless and forgetting about the fact that you want to achieve a result out of it, right? But the poet seems to hear a very careless behavior of the poet seems to appear. But the cherries have a way of growing. Although the poet is not determined, but you can see the determination all coming through in the cherry tree. Though no one's caring very much and knowing. Nobody knew about his intentions and nobody knew the fact that he has planted a tree, such a tree over there. And it started growing on its own. And suddenly that summer, near the end of May, I found a tree had come to stay. So this is something very surprising. The poet had altogether forgotten about the fact that he had done something. And what does he notice? He has noticed a tree had come to stay. A small plant has sprouted and it's almost 5 months child, 5 months old, okay? So it is, you can see that growth of 5 months. But it has not come to anybody's notice. Why? It is lost in the tall grass running wild. So you could see tall grass everywhere. And amidst that, this small tree has sprouted. So no, it has not caught the attention of anybody. But see, the life of this cherry tree is not so very easy. See, the goats ate the leaves and the grass cutter scythe. See, the goats have eaten away the leaves of the plant. And to add to its misery, the grass cutter has cut it off with his tool. Okay, with that equipment, the tree has been cut short. It has been split apart and the monsoon blight. So to add to it, the damage, you know, has also been caused. A lot of damage has been caused by the monsoon there. Shrivel, poor thing, you know, it had to, it has sustained all the challenges. So it's something great. Shriveled the slender stem. Shriveled meaning it has got dried, almost on the verge of drying. And even so, next spring, I watched 3 new shoots grow. So this is something unbelievable. Okay, you could see the, what do you say, the determination of the plant to grow in spite of the fact that it has been cut, it had to face the monsoon, okay, the goats have eaten it up, the struggle, you know, to start again from zero. Upward thrust, it is trying to grow up, facing all the challenges, its arms in fresh fierce lust, you know, its arms, it is spreading its branches, you know, and it is going upward, touching the sky, and it has a lust to lust here, meaning that desire here, that extreme desire to, you know, because plants need light, air, sun, these are all the elements necessary for a plant to grow. So it is growing upward. I could only wait as one. What is the poet doing? You know, poet is not doing anything. He is only watching, waiting, watching, wondering, and time and rain. Time has done its wonders. You know, rain, it required the rain as well. So rain also has done the wonders, right? Made a miracle. All these elements have, you know, acted upon the plant and has really created a miracle. Made a miracle from a green growing paint. So it has, you know, given the strength for the plant to grow in spite of all the pain and the torture that the plant had to undergo. Okay, so I hope you have understood the poem until here. Okay, so we will continue this poem in the next video lecture. Thank you.